What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Carney from the Carney League, and I just wanted to give you a heads up that today's match is special. If you didn't notice by the title already, we have a mirror match on the ZU Ladder Tournament. Yes, the ladder tour that's going on right now. Creeper and I somehow almost built the exact same team. It is crazy, because I don't think I uploaded a video of this team at all. It is crazy, but link to the team is going to be down in the description down below. As well, put a paste pin if you want to hop on, start learning the ZU tier. I make example teams and do lives normally with them. Well, this one right here though, this is a magical day. This is a magical day. We have a best 2 out of 3. Basically, on the ladder tournament. And if you don't know what the ZU ladder tournament is, basically it's just a tournament where the top four every week qualify for playoffs. And if they qualify for playoffs in the ladder tournament, it's a playoffs bracket after that, and the winner is the champion. So it goes on for a month, the qualifications, and I think it's like 2 weeks, 4 weeks, 3 weeks of actual play. So let's just hop into it. This went really fast. I'm gonna be leading off Star Journal looking at this man's team, because I know my team's really ground weak, and that's why we have Thwacky on the team. So Earthquake is just really, really strong. And looking at his team, I know that Earthquake's super strong, so I'm just going to lead on with that first of all. Storm Turner goes for the Earthquake, ends up getting a critical hit on the Swalot, and then that might matter later on, but Swalot reveals it's the Toxic Protect set, so this means that it's Toxic Protect, it's not Acid Armor, mostly like Special Move, like Sludge Bomb and Ice Beam, that's what they tend to be running here. I end up switching into Miss Lagoo on the Thwacky, because I'm obviously Sap Sipper, and here comes the Grumpig. Grumpig goes for the trick, gives me choice specs. I go for the Iron Head. If you don't know, Grumpig is like super centralizing in this metagame right now, and it's kind of hard to not build a team around Grumpig and or have counterplay for Grumpig. So I have a choice scarf Grumpig, he has a choice specs Grumpig. I'm going to be using that knowledge later on. But right now, I go for the Headbutt, like I said, the Iron Head. Do 47, he's got Evil Light now, and he does 40% to me, which is kind of scary, but luckily I'm getting some residual healing. If I wasn't giving him residual healing, he would have been 2-hit KO'd there, which is completely fine. In comes Stormjourner as Thwacky comes in, Earthquake happens, and I see the Life Orb chick, and I'm like, oh no. So I end up knocking off the Life Orb, because Life Orb Stormjourner is actually really, really strong. It hits like a truck. But the Heavy Slam comes out as I go straight into my pick. I know that I can go for an Earth Power here, just because it hits Stone, it hits Swalot, and it hits Thwacky upon switching. As I'm going to be sacking off my Sligoo, but I'm going to get a couple flinches first. You know, doing mini Dunsparce stuff, as it ends up revealing that it is a Curse Iron Headset also. But for him, he's actually kind of crazy. He's actually Curse, Iron Head, and Sleep Talk. So it's kind of, you know, it's kind of Rest, Sleep Talk. Meanwhile, I'm Curse, Iron Head, Rest, and Ice Spinner at the moment. I end up changing it to Ice Beam because it handles Stone General just a little bit more better, in my opinion, as he ends up Terra Grounding, and I'm kind of scared. But Swalot, it's in here, man. Swalot with plus four right now. Crazy bulky. I'm so glad. So now, so you guys know, my Swalot set doesn't even change. I'm Sticky Hold with Body Press, so I am Armor Press with Earthquake as my last move for fellow Swalot. The EQs are hitting me, and they're hitting me hard, buddy. Like, I'm like, bruh, what's going on? But we end up taking out the Mon, but the Stone Journey is going through. Legendre misses the first one as... So my thing of not simply attacking is, if you hit a Will-O-Wisp here, body press is already halved, so like there's no point of getting the chip damage, as I need to be at max to actually do some like max defense to do some damage here, as Willow's still coming out. I'm hoping that I can get another miss here, but he Willow hits at turn 28, and if I wasn't Willowist, I'm doing 60%. It's kind of crazy because this is heavy duty boots, as he reveals that his move of choice is Flare Blitz. Meanwhile, my move of choice is sadly Hurricane. But Hurricane comes in more handy, like long term. Hurricane comes in handy versus a lot of matchups that I feel like my team has a hard time with. But end up pressing down the Fletchinger on this game right here. Here comes Swalot. Swalot's pressing to protect, as of course you would. I'm currently burnt though, so that means I'm not doing any damage to this man, even at 12%. And the reason why I didn't go for body press here is simply because body press does less. I think it does like 4% or something like that. Like, does the burn. It's not even that as strong, but Earthquake just does a little bit more. As he ends up Earthquaking me, so he's Earthquake and Sludge Bomb. I go to the pig, I press Earth Power, because Earth Power hits Sliggy, it hits the Thwacky. It hits the Wacky for neutral, but I can always get the Death Drop like I just did right here. But since I am Choice Scarfed, I'm just going to switch in my my little Sliggy, just because if you wanted to go for a hammer there or whatever, like a wood hammer. Turns out this thing is Choice Scarfed, so if you end up going for wood hammer, actually I potentially could have won the game right there. But it's a completely A-OK. He ends up pressing the U-turn, making the better play. He is the better player, as I'm pressing Psy Shock here. And yeah, it's kind of revealing that I have no way of hitting the man, the myth, the legend, Sliggy, as he now knows that I am. Then I'm going to go with my Thwacky here, just because I really want to get rid of the item that's on Sliggoo, and just pressing knockoff is the strongest thing for me to do here. Taking out the Evilite, so now all my hits actually do a lot more damage. I'm going to swap right back into my pig, as that Iron Head does way too much, and he reveals that he's actually like somewhat specially defensive vested, which is kind of crazy. But instead of going for it's okay, I am loaded dice, so instead of going for the Earthquake and guaranteeing this kill, actually I think I calced it and I think it didn't guarantee the kill or whatever for some reason, but if I hit 5 Rock Blast hits, it guaranteed the kill. I was calculating with the Evilite on and not with it off, so it's fine. That or I was trying to catch Thwacky on the switch in, but whatever. My Stonejourner comes through, hits like 50 million times, dude. I'm telling you, man, Rock Blast Stonejourner with loaded dice is strong. Comes my Fletchlander as I go for the Will-O-Wisp here, just in case if he was Earthquake. Like Acid Armor or BMP Jab or something. I just wanted to whittle him down a little bit. As I go for Hurricane, here comes the Sludge Bomb, and I'm like, bro, why am I missing? So I'm gonna go for the Roost here. He can go for the EQ, instead he ends up going for Sludge Bomb. I guess it does a lot. So I'm gonna go for one last Hurricane right here, just trying to catch him off guard, and I just wasn't able to do it in time. So I go in my Thwacky, I tear a grass, and it has a chance to kill, but it doesn't. 27%. Boom. There goes game number one. My boy Creeper. Oh man, he won the first game. Well, let's go into game number two. This actually happens like shortly after. I told myself I'm not losing to this guy again. I did the same lead because, like I said, his whole team's, his team's really like Stonejourner weak, as Swalot goes for the poison. But I'm going to get off my rocks early because I know he's going to protect, since I just played him like a few hours ago. And this also, like, the adaptation and going game one, going to game two, this is like where you have to like understand what you did wrong in the matchup and adapt. And that's exactly what I'm doing right here, as I'm trying my best to adapt. In comes the Sliggoo on the Shuttle Ball. Does absolutely nothing. I know I can go to my Swalot here. Ends up going to back in his pick, going to my Sliggoo, knowing that he's a Choice Scarf or Specs. I'm sorry, knowing that he's Choice Specs, that I can always switch in. I do end up getting the Iron Head crit onto the Thwacky. And I even type in, I'm sorry, man, as I end up ice spinning to get rid of the passive heals, and then meanwhile going back into my Thwacky to get up the terrain and being able to chew a hit from Stonejourner. Also, Swalot, Stonejourner, my team has a hard time switching into Stonejourner as a heavy slam. But Swalot tastes like a champ, honestly, as now I'm at the point where it can be a roll. So what I end up doing is I go into my Fletchender trying to proc the flame body, and I end up getting the flame body, which is kind of crazy. And here comes Sligoo. The Sligoo is so bulky right now at the moment too. And this is actually what prompts me to start cursing up. Just kidding. I end up dying. I press curse there for I don't know what reason, but I'm gonna go in Thwacky, going for the wood hammer, taking out the Stonejourner. Now it's currently a 5v4 action. U-turning, popping out, just trying to get into a better position. I know he's toxic now, toxic sludge bomb and earthquake. That means he cannot touch my Swalot, and I'm just gonna go for the press because I already know that he can't touch me, so I'm gonna be able to touch him later. It's weird, but I end up doing nothing but barring getting so much health back. I'm at 81% now, which is kind of crazy. And I know that I am a choice Scarfed variant. I know Psychic should not kill me at this range, or at least it has a chance not to kill me, and it doesn't kill me. So unless he got like another high roll, which is fine. So I would go for Shadow Ball here. I end up getting the Spidef drop, which ends up like not mattering as much because he just presses Protect. Now he's out of Shadow Ball range to begin with, but he ends up switching to Sligoo too, as I'm going to go streaking my Fletchender. I know that he is a rest set, but I need to get my Fletchender in, and I need to get a defog off, as I know he's going to go for the rest here. So now my my pick can actually come through and have some fun. But first things first, he is cursing up, and he's swearing like a sailor at the moment. But I go for the body press, just trying to chip down Sligoo just a little bit. That and or catch the Grumpig on the switch in. But here it is. This is when he reveals like he's like really offensive on his Swalot, and I'm like, bro. And I notice that Stonejourner doesn't do anything right now, so yeah, it's kind of crazy. I end up going for the Psy Shock back to the Swalot as he goes for the Iron Head. That's way too much damage. And I go Thwacky, trying to predict the pig to come in. Instead, Fletchlinger comes in. So now I have to go into my Fletchlinger, and now he changed. Like this, I'm telling you, this is like adaptation, right? So he changes Flare Blitz and puts on Flame. He puts on, I mean, he changes Flare Blitz to put on Brave Bird, so then he can actually handle like the Mons the next time he sees me. It's kind of crazy, but I end up hitting my Hurricane here, as we both know this is a speed tie, and yeah. Down I go, but I'm gonna go straight for the Shadow Ball just in case. If you want to go into the pig, I get the Spidef drop as I go into my Swalot. I know Swalot is so good right now at the moment, and the only thing I have to do is predict one turn right and able to get it. Do I get the flame body prop? I do not. My Swalot's still in. Here comes the pig. I go straight in my Thwacky, end up chewing the psychic. Like, this is coming so close, and I go for the knockoff, get rid of its evil light, and this is what's gonna help me actually win the game. As I end up pressing Sword Stance on the Iron Head, knowing that it wouldn't potentially KO me. And then I go for the knockoff again, just trying to get as much chip as possible, as humanly possible. So my pig can come in and press Earth Power and die. Oh no, you might be thinking, bro, it's legit Swalot versus the world at the moment. And this Sligoo just revealed that it's Terra Water. It's kind of scary, right? But my Swalot comes in. I acid armored up. I take it like a champ. And I'm like, wait a second. I need to get healthy. Because if I don't get healthy, I lose this game. So, I acid armor up again. Goes for the rest. So while it's not looking like he's in a good position, but I know I need to max out my defense so I can take it like a champ. Take it like a champ. As I do 49%, because he is no longer evil lighted. This is not super effective damage. I have to press protect this turn. If he goes for the rest, it means that I get more chances to heal myself, as I know that I need to get out of range of of Specs Pig, and I'm evil. I'm PB'd to where I can live one hit from Specs Pig if I get to the exact HP amount, which I think is like 90% or something like that. Like, I have to be at 90%. Gosh darn near full. But here it goes. I'm at 83 now. I'm like, all right, this is where I need to start committing. I'm pressing a body press here. It ends up cursing because I've been protecting between turns. But now I'm at 89%. That means I'm at 95%. As long as he does not get a crit, I will win this game because I protect. I take the hit 77%. Doesn't matter. Body press ends up winning me this game. This is round two. GG round two. I end up winning this game. Weeks go on by. I don't see Creeper on the ladder. And then, just recently, I ran into him. He's got the same team. But it's been weeks. We don't know each other's sets. We don't know if we've changed. I haven't changed. Well, I have changed. I've changed terror types, and I think I've EV'd a little bit differently. But here it goes. Game number three. Who will win? Who will die? Let's get into it. I make sure to tell him we meet again. We are 1-1. And this time, okay, so every single time, he's lead off with Swalot. His game plan is simple. I lead off with Swalot. I get Toxic down, or I get Toxic Spikes up. I get something going. For me, my game plan is simple. I'm going out big damage. That is what I want to do. I look at this man's team. Simple. Earth power looks so strong. So I go into my Scarf pick. I press Earth power. I do 45%. He ends up hitting the Toxic. I switch into my Swalot, realizing the set's kind of crazy. And in comes his Fletchender as I Acid Armor up. I know that he's going to Will-O-Wisp here. So I switch into my Fletchender just to chew the Will-O-Wisp. In comes the Sliggoo. Guess what? I Hurricane. I did 5%, and that was big damage. And then I end up staying in to Will-O-Wisp. And he goes to go into the Stonejourner. I finally hit the second Will-O-Wisp, but boom. My Fletchender dies to Stone Edge. So I'm like, all right. I know my Stonejourner is going to win this game for me, but I got to play it correctly. So since I know he's burnt, I can actually Rock Polish up, showing him that my Stonejourner is kind of crazy. I'm down to 32%, and here it comes. The Thwacky comes in, and I count. I'm like, yo, Thwacky dies. Thwacky dies. If I'm a little saucy, Thwacky dies. So I stay in, I Rock Blast, 22, 19, 19, 21, 7. I get the 5 hit from the loaded dice. Oh my goodness, it's so good. It's so good. As Thwacky ends up going down, Sliggoo comes in, right? But guess what? I'm Terra Ground because I was Terra Rock all this time. Now I'm Terra Ground at Earthquake. I do 50%. Here comes the Fletchender. 99. 1%. Good night, Fletchender. As I'm getting healthy. In comes the Pig. If I hit the Rock Blast, I win. Critical hit. But it doesn't even matter. It was going to hit 4 times either way. Oh my goodness. In comes the GGs. Comes the Terra Water. And I miss the Rock Blast. Knowing it just... And then he ends up actually forfeiting. I said, glad I knew I was going to miss. And then I even asked him, hey, do you mind if I make this into a video? And of course, he said yes. So that's the chronicle of the mirror match of me versus Creeper. I just wanted to tell you guys, this has been a fun CU ladder tournament. I am finally like in the mix now. So I'm kind of having fun. But I need to hit top 4, so I'm going to be trying to do that later on. Thursday, we actually might be doing a stream until I'm like at 1300s or whatever. But until then, guys, I want to say thank you guys for watching, and I'll see y'all later. Bye.